Namaste, angels. I'm going to do a couple of client readings. We should have some really good energy for it. It's 38 degrees here, so 11. It's 11:11 a.m. on Friday, the 31st, the last day of the month. And this day is an 8, actually. More build, destroy. More if you're not with us, you're against us, basically. If you're not part of the solution, you are part of the problem. So I'm going to read for somebody who... I do not know. However, I can tell by her words, the words she used, the way that I could hear her voice when she wrote. She is, you know, certainly a loyal supporter, not just of me, but, you know, of the message of the word, which is, you know, more important than of me. You know, I'm here to show you to the light, help you to get there. But the light is more important than I am. So the destination is what really matters. So I'm happy to read for her. She was wondering if her divine masculine was among those interested in maybe moving in together. So if we see the Nine of Water... and or the star, I'll certainly take that as a yes. I think I'll do the cross for her first to see what the masculine is thinking in general. And then we'll do a spread. Okay, so I'm going to begin with the Queen of Water, who's tenderhearted, empathetic, patient, and loving. Relationships develop to a new level. Trust your intuition. Care for yourself and others. The Queen of Water is a Scorpio, Cancer, or Pisces. I also saw a lot of air, like the Queen of Swords, or air, rather. The Libra, you know, the Justice card. I saw... something else that made me think. Maybe I did see the star already as I was shuffling. I think I did. So there may be an air and water combination, which I spoke of this week in the readings. I said I saw those, you know, making some comebacks, and perhaps specifically Cancer and Libra and or Gemini and Scorpio. So I don't know that she is either of those, but, you know, we'll get to see. So opening to the page of fire, maybe somebody's a fire sign, or, you know, sun, moon, or rising. Outgoing, creative, confident, and mischievous is the page of fire. News of an exciting new endeavor. Use your originality and ingenuity. The page of fire is a Sagittarius, most likely to me, or an Aries, or a Leo. I say Sagittarius first because the page is the youthful one, and the Sagittarius is the youthful of the fire signs. Queen of Water back. Opening to the Seven of Fire. Defend your beliefs and decisions. Stand your ground. Choose your battles wisely. The Queen of Water back. And opening to the Five of Earth. Fear surrounding money. The wisdom to accept help from others. And uncertain self-employment. So the Five of Earth... particularly right now during this Venus retrograde for me is a very abandonment issue. You know, I've got abandonment issues card. And right after that, another five, which I'm not a fan of fives in general, to be honest. It's the Five of Air. An unwise choice. Learn what you can from this situation. Review everyone's motives. So this one for me is the one that is about conflict in which we've had a hand ourselves. Whether it was inadvertent, you know, subconsciously, you know, without malice, we still help to put some things in motion that worked out against us in the end. Or, you know, somebody we love, those about whom we care. And we come to realize that we were involved, we played a part. That Five of Earth about the abandonment issues and or lack of, you know, some sort of abundance, whether it's love or money, is back. And the overall energy is the eight of air, an illusion of being trapped, a lack of self-confidence, and being afraid to take action. So here we'll have, again, what the feminine is feeling about herself, or, you know, in relation to everything. Then what the masculine is feeling specifically about her, then specifically about himself, then about the union, then the overall, and the outcome. Feminine is the queen of earth, who's thoughtful, creative, warm, and sensible. Make time for those around you. Take a sensible approach and deal with challenges in a kind and understanding manner. So if this woman for whom I'm reading is not a Virgo, Capricorn, or Taurus, she's at least feeling right now comfortable with regard to finances, which is awesome, but also thoughtful. More importantly, thoughtful, creative, warm, and sensible, and willing to think things through and not just pop off, you know, yeah, face these challenges in as understanding, you know, with as much compassion as possible. She's also willing to make time for those around her to sort of be able to balance like work and play. The masculine sees her as the six of air, or the energy surrounding her. Things are looking up. It's the end of a difficult situation. You may even be taking the trip. So he sees her as forward moving and have someone with whom he'd like to move forward. Very nice. He sees himself as the king of earth, who is generous, professional, responsible, and practical. A successful time. Confidently accept opportunities you're offered. You have the Midas touch. So he's feeling very good right now, and it sounds like things are going well for him too. But he's tired, or he's feeling like the union is tired. It's strained. He wants it to persevere. He wants it to maintain, but he feels the strain on it. Don't give up. Protect that which you've created. Have courage and believe in yourself. Very nice. Overall, a very happy family life. Financial security and finding the magic in the little things in life. And the outcome is the Emperor with Archangel Michael. Organization and logic, structure and discipline and leadership. So this card representing the sign of Aries. So maybe fire is being reintroduced. We've seen, therefore, three elements thus far, which can be, you know, a combination of the two people, sun, moon, or rising, fire, earth, and water. It sounds like he is moving toward something. He's working very hard for this stability foundation, perhaps. Yes, maybe, you know, a home. That's what fours represent. But not yet. Not yet. So he does want to move forward with you. That's evident here. He's doing well lately, a lot better than he's been doing before. You know, and he... It looks like, in general, for the two of you, things will continue to go well, but he's not ready yet. So this is a card of perseverance, the Knight of Fire, the need to continue to press forward, push forward, but we're not quite ready to put down our wand. We're still at the ready. We're still in defense mode, and that is perhaps while we continue to get ourselves organized and you know, prepared, because we're not ready yet. Something we at least feel that we're bound to something at the moment that's not allowing us to move completely forward yet, or, you know, to put these wands down yet, but that's coming. And when I picked this up, what was behind it upright is indeed the Four of Fire. Contentment, peace, and abundance, a happy home life, and the successful completion of a project. So again, this stability, this four, very near, this Emperor wanting to provide that to you, but There's still a little bit more work to be done. The fight's not over yet. Underneath that is justice. It's upside down, so doesn't necessarily apply, at least in this moment, but it is near. Fair and just decisions. Do what you know is right and stand up for your beliefs. And behind that, seven of air, upright. I mean, it does continue to get better, these cards, but again, they don't really apply right now because that justice upside down. Okay, so now I'm going to, I don't want to spend too much time looking at it. It's a video, so you can stop, rewind, look at the cards, see what you got. They're awesome, but I got to shuffle a little bit again to make this for real. So I don't want to spend too much time. I don't know if you saw, we had the Nine of Earth, the Ten of Fire. So these are more, the Nine of Earth is an indication that, yeah, some time alone needs to still be spent, but alone but happy. You know, alone, not lonely. Then I saw the Ten of Fire, so that comes after the Nine. That's trying to get to a place where you can put the Wands down, but we're not quite there yet, as I was saying. And now Justice, Major Arcana card Justice, which does represent the sign of Libra, as I was saying earlier. And the Dreamer, which represents for me the signs of Gemini and Virgo, because Archangel Metatron in this card in particular represents this planet Mercury for me, which rules both Gemini and Virgo. Justice is back. And now the Chariot. So as I was saying again earlier, I did see some unions perhaps for Cancer and Libra. And this can still be Sun, Moon, or Rising. Justice back. I'm going to cut. Want to make sure we get the cards good and mixed up. And the Emperor's back at the top. Okay, so before I use those any further, I'm going to go on to these. The Romance cards, beginning with Playfulness. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. And opening to Soulmate. Very nice. Yes, this is your soulmate. Love when we can get that out of the way right away, right from the beginning. Playfulness back also represents for me the signs of Gemini and Sagittarius. Opening two, let your friends help you. Ask for and accept support from others. Playfulness back. And retreat, it's time to disconnect from the world. But playfulness remains. I'm going to cut, and then we'll do a cross with these cards. And it's wedding. This situation involves marriage. So maybe not just moving in together, some sort of really serious commitment, which can be of the legal kind. Maybe that's why justice keeps showing up here, to represent the legality of the whole thing. And the overall energy is keep an open mind. Your soulmate, so here's another reference to this being your soulmate, may differ from your usual type and expectations. So here you are with regard to yourself. Here he is, R-E-U. Here he is with regard to himself and with regard to the union. This overall and this outcome. You ready for new love, ready for a new start. Okay, maybe everything had gotten stale. And we just saw a new path, okay? We just saw the Fool, which I said represented for me the signs of Gemini and Virgo. But aside from that, it's the Fool. It's a brand new path. It's zero. It's God force. It's stepping out on faith. On top of that, God force. And, you know, blindly maybe. Looks like her eyes are kind of closed. But she's headed toward this page-like young man or something, maybe a page of fire. Maybe that's what you have as well. It's for a brand new start. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. He feels about you passion. You help him to allow his heart and soul to sing with joy. He feels about himself that he deserves love. Amen. I love seeing this. How often do we feel we don't deserve love and like, I'm never going to find it because no one's interested in me. He likes himself. He loves himself. I'm so happy to see this. You are lovable. He knows it already. I don't have to tell him. And the union, reconciliation, someone from your past is returning to your life. I saw this as I was shuffling too. I said, oh, they're in separation. Because again, I don't know this woman. She didn't talk to me about anything. I told you money had been a problem. It is no longer. Finances and career are the overall situation for you guys right now. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. When he has the money to do exactly what he wants to do, he will do it. He'll make those moves. You know, maybe the moving in, maybe the wedding, you know, or some higher level of commitment or whatever. Right now, what's important, he's ready. He's coming back for you guys to begin on a new path together. And it'll be necessary. This is the outcome, forgiving and learning. Okay, so it'll be necessary for you to draw on that queen of earth that you saw yourself as. As you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moments. Okay, so let's get a good look at these, and I'm going to take them away, because I got to do the same thing and shuffle them real quick so that they'll be ready for the spread. Opening to soulmate again right away. Yes, this is your soulmate, but he's affected by the finances and career right now. Finances and career. Opening to give your relationship a chance. Work on your partnership. Okay, and that keep an open mind is back too. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. And again, and now religious factors. Your love life is influenced by your religious upbringing and spiritual path. So he may be one of these that if he is tied to something or you're tied to something, he's not ready to move until that's cleared up. And in addition to that, he wants to do things, quote unquote, right. So he's trying to make sure he has a certain amount of money or has certain things in order, that they are organized, they're prepared, plans best laid and all that kind of stuff. And when I picked this up to show you that it was the overall, guess what was underneath it? That eight of air that was the overall before, that illusion of being trapped. So he may be thinking that the reason he's trapped is because of money, like he doesn't have enough yet. And so he's still bound to stay away from you until he's finished getting organized. However, I don't know. Underneath that is the Ace of Air. It's upside down, so not necessarily for now, but the truth will set you free too. That also can mean victory ahead. Not yet, but soon, victory on the horizon. So again, okay, you know what? I'm going to cut here. Give your relationship a chance. Work on your partnership. And the overall energy is honeymoon. Enjoy the bliss of holiday time together. That can be the honeymoon phase of a relationship. It can be an actual holiday time that's coming up. You were guided before to take a retreat, to get away from the world. Maybe, you know, weekend away. That dice has been showing up all week. Things like that. Underneath this is heart-to-heart conversations in reverse, you know, upside down. Okay, so back here, the Emperor. I'm going to shuffle these in my hand for a second and then lay them. Overall energy here is the Three of Fire. Abundance. Things look very good. Have patience at this time and make long-term plans. So again, I think that's what the masculine is doing already. And he asks you to do the same thing although your patience, if it's reflected by that nine of fire, may be wearing thin, you know, as may his, but he's still in the fight. He wants you to continue to be in the fight too, basically. He's still the king of earth, and I'm still the goddamn magician. How you like that? I'm so tired of these people messing with me. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to break into your reading, but I'm really tired of these fools messing with me every day. I am who I am. You are you who you are. That applies to everybody, everywhere. We're supposed to be in this together. And if we are, we'll stop all the madness and just accept, you know, our individual places and purposes in all of this, and then come together and collaborate and use each one, okay, together. As I'm trying to do right now, I'm using mine with this young woman with whom I'm dealing so that she can use hers with her masculine, the king of earth, who is generous, professional, responsible, and practical still. A successful time. Confidently accept opportunities you're offered. You have the Midas touch. Surrounded by the eight of earth, skilled work is rewarded. So he's been putting a lot of effort into a lot of stuff. It's paying off. Learning all there is to know about a topic and going back to school. But maybe a little bit overly focused on the money he's trying to make in order. Maybe he doesn't know or believe what I'm sure you feel is that you don't need all this stuff. You'd rather just have him. But I don't know. I mean, I have the same issue, and I think many of us do. I've been seeing it in the readings for the collective feminine in general, that these masculine, they want to be able to give us something that they feel they can't right now. And so that is why they're still out there, like busting their butts, working themselves, you know, quote unquote, to death, as they say. Hopefully not really actually doing that. I don't think actually doing that, but just working too much in a lot of cases. Because of a false sense of entrapment. They feel bound to something. They're overly focused on material things. And they have negative and fear-based thoughts as a result. Like, I don't have enough. How am I going to do this? How's this going to work? Where am I going to get this money? And, you know, that can lead to all kinds of negativity that you manifest into your own life when you do that. We've got to let all that kind of stuff go. Realize, yeah, love is all you need. Is that song, was that the Beatles, right? All you need is love. Yes, absolutely, the Beatles. This is also very close to, at least for me, the eight of air that we saw before. It's about feeling bound to something. Now, that something can be money, right? Like the love of money. Money as in, you know, like a god. And if that's the case, we gotta break that too. You know, the idolatry of money. No good. Talk about that in the book of Timothy. Timothy 2 talks about how money becomes a god, and it's very dangerous that is for us. Couldn't be other things too, though. Feeling tied to something, someplace, someone, and maybe that's why needing more money, or at least feeling that way, that we need more money in order to break away from this thing. You know, I'd like to run away from home, but I can't until, you know, I have a suitcase full of cash, that type of thing. Feminine. The moon with Archangel Haniel. Important psychic insights, events behind the scenes. Release fears that hold you back. So the moon represents the sign of Pisces or other water sign, which was already sort of reflected here in this reading that a water sign, sun, moon, or rising might be present. As does this, that's for sure. The two of water are relationships that continues to grow closer. Beautiful. Forgiveness and the positive resolution of a conflict. So I'm glad to see this forgiveness, that you're willing to do that, that energy surrounds you, your willingness to forgive, because you're going to need it, as we saw was evidenced by the last little spread that I did. In your subconscious, however, the five of water. So it's like, despite all the wonderful energy that we've seen and things perhaps going on in your life, you're still like, oh, woe is me. You got to get out of that. Same way he has to get out of this energy that he's in with the ego. This is ego too. It's not called ego. In this card isn't called ego like his is, but it's still ego. It's still, I got these two big, beautiful, shiny cups, but I'm worried about these two. Like, I'm greedy. I want everything. I'm, you know, there's no pleasing me. I don't appreciate anything. I'm not very thankful. And, you know, I just deserve more in spite of it. Like, who cares? We don't want to be that person. Crowning. It's the Hermit with Archangel Raziel. Spend time in quiet meditation, spiritual teaching, and self-discovery. This is about going within. So while you continue to spend a little bit more time alone in preparation for this reconciliation, the reuniting that will occur between the two of you, you got even, and it's like regardless of whatever that means, if it means a day, you got to spend 24 hours by yourself still. Use that 24 hours to go within and continue to discover, to learn more of yourself, to teach yourself more of yourself. Maybe that'll help you to get over whatever this is about. Maybe that'll help him to get over whatever this is about. At the root, the Ace of Water. Falling in love or the resurgence of a relationship. This is all about your reconciliation too. Spiritual growth and enhanced intuition, similar to the moon. Okay, use that intuition. You may even be getting a new home. More four. Although the ace is a one or an 11, actually. At the heart of the matter, the Knight of Earth. So it's coming, but it's a little slow. It's a little slow. This is more patience is required. Loyal, dedicated, honorable, and kind is the Knight of Earth. It's time to buckle down and get things done. Honor your commitments. You have a guardian angel. Here atop the King of Earth is children. Your love life is being affected by children. So this might be why he feels bound, why he feels he needs more money. Maybe he has children outside of his relationship with you. And before he is comfortable, I don't want to say leaving them because he's not going to leave them. Maybe leaving the home that he may share with them. That's a possibility. But they will always be part of his life. But before he feels comfortable moving away from them, maybe metaphorically and or physically, that may be why he's trying to build up the money first. This also can have something to do with children between the two of you, or a child, a baby, a pregnancy, maybe even with the Ace of Water sitting here at the root. And that would be another reason why he feels he needs more money, he needs more money, he needs more money, you know, to make everything right. Here, one of the things that he's putting this hard work into that's soon to be rewarded with the Eight of Earth, skilled work is rewarded, is calling in your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help bring you together. So that work that he's doing is the calling in, is the praying, is the visualizing. Here, atop ego, or the devil, is playfulness. So he is to, you know, let go of this stress that he's bringing upon himself and just be more light, happy, airy, you know, get out of this head, because it does become potentially problematic, even as health is concerned, high blood pressure, all this kind of stuff, by being constantly worried about money and things. Here atop the moon. And diagonal to his devil, interestingly, is codependency. Addictions are affecting your romantic life. So addictions can also have something, and the devil can also reflect addictions, as can that eight of air. Now, addictions doesn't have to mean substance, doesn't have to mean alcohol, doesn't have to mean drugs. It can. But it doesn't have to be. But it could also be any person, place, thing to which you feel bound or he feels bound, and it affects both of you. So it could be on the other, on his other family, or this could be you. You could be the one with the children. It could be on his mind. How am I going to help her to take care of her children, you know, without more money? I need more money. And you could be feeling, you know, bound to that. Or maybe to your children's other parent. How can I help her to not need that other man so much, you know, since their romantic relationship is over and they don't have a very good non-romantic relationship? How can I remove him from that position of power and authority over her that he's in? I got to make more money to help her with the children. You know, that's another possibility. Here, top the two of water, of course. Makes perfect sense. Romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. Here atop the five of water, let your friends help you. Ask for and accept support from others. So maybe you need your friends to help you to count your blessings or to remind you about what's good in your life. Maybe that to show you, remind you of how much you're loved and cared for, and how much fun you used to be when you weren't sitting around, you know, moping and, oh, woe is me-ing and stuff like that. Maybe that's what they can help you to do. Atop the hermit, so after you go within, you're being guided to come out and express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. At the root here atop the ace of water, let go of control issues and allow this situation to unfold naturally. So somebody's trying to direct the new beginning, maybe. Wanted to go a certain way, asking the universe for specifically for, you know, what they want, how they want it, when they want. And the universe doesn't like that. It says, please don't do that. Let go of control issues. And wait patiently with the Knight of Earth. He's coming. He's always gets to his destination. He's not going to let you down. He never has let anybody down. He always makes it to the end. So, you know, he's got this. You let go of it. Don't worry about it. But atop the Knight of Earth is religious factors is back. Your love life is influenced by your religious upbringing, spiritual path. So again, I think, and it's here, crossing the children, in between the calling in of the soulmate and the romantic feelings, the two of water. So I think that this is in great part about wanting to make the traditional, you know, quote unquote traditional family and do things the right way. How they used to say, make an honest woman out of you. Real commitment, real, you know, coming together, taking care of the kids. You know, he's the provider, all that kind of stuff. Let me get you some advice. So, from the angels, they say to the masculine, you know, that he should pick up speed. He should pick up speed. Stop, yeah, put this down, the devil energy down, and pick up speed with the Knight of Air. Intelligent, decisive, idealistic, and tireless is the Knight of Air. He's also a Gemini, Libra, or an Aquarius. Events that occur with great speed. Take time to carefully review your options so you can come up with creative solutions. He's ready to take off running this way. And spirit encourages him to go ahead and do that. I was just moved to pick up the Three of Fire in regard to it being perhaps about a party of three and not, you know, in addition to being about abundance. At least a party of three that perhaps has come to an end, or maybe that these children could be the third. And behind that is this star. Remember I said if we see the star, I'll let you know that, yes, everything is going to come together. That'll be our yes from spirit. Here it is. The star representing the sign of Aquarius, which can be, again, what this Knight of Air is about. Here with Archangel Jophiel, happy times, make positive, optimistic, long-term plans. Same thing this Three of Fire says. Make long-term plans. You're on the right path. Yes. To you from the angels, it's the Chariot back again with Archangel Metatron, representing the sign of Cancer or other water sign. An important achievement, self-discipline and willpower, public recognition. This is you being guided to move this way. I want you to see his advice from the angels and your advice from the angels. Okay, you're both guided to move toward the middle, toward one another, and express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. From the romance angels to the masculine retreat, it's time to disconnect from the world. So this will be his hermit time, where he does this introspection and figures out the rest of how he's going to do all this, accomplish his goals. In the meantime, you will patiently wait. You will be that nine of fire that he's asking you to be, and persevere. And it will turn out to be worth waiting for. It's in your favor. Divine timing is at work in your love life. I hope that you enjoyed your reading, dear. Namaste, angel.